Hi, I'm George Cipriani.
Just joined the crime squad.
They sit over there.
Yeah. Have any of you ever worked with Sergeant Sands?
Come in.
Excuse me, sir. Sergeant Sands, why is he on leave?
Sands? Stress, I think. Do you want chapter and verse?
Don't know yet.
Well, I know he's badly beaten up by a gang of yobs.
Not the football, do.
That's right. For his trouble, he was hauled before a disciplinary hearing. Young lad put in a complaint. He had a rough time of it, all right.
That was years ago.
Oh, well, you know how these things are. Suppose it finally caught up with him. You getting anywhere with the son?
He insists he was at home, sir. But if that's home, I'd rather be in Alcatraz. The atmosphere. You could cut it for a knife.
Have you found the knife?
No, sir. But I've arranged for the DCI to go through their cutlery drawer. That should put her mind at rest.
So who would you say his mates were?
I think he sort of withdrew. That was his problem. He was like a loner.
I think he was having counselling.
But he'd never tell you, would he? Very private.
Hey.
It's just a touch.
Now look!
Have you ever been in an interview?
What?
I know why people confess. It's scary just being there. I'm sitting there looking at you like they know you've done it, whether you have or not.
All right, what do you want? A medal? It's no big deal, you know.
What do you think of this?
I don't think, all right? But I don't think nothing. I don't want to talk about nothing. Now look, I'm trying to do me now.
Right?
This is my room, Rory.
Hey. Can you believe Dad would...
Don't talk to me about Dad. I hate him. I hate him. I hate him. Now you get out of my room.
Shh. No. No. If you want to run a bit of skirt back to Brighton, then take the dog with you. Stephen?
Just to say what we used to do at our house. My dad used to lock us in the bedroom if we'd been naughty.
Sorry, you want me to lock you in your bedroom? Listen, Kelvin, it's your dog. I've got better things to do than walk your dog. I don't like walking. Sorry, what have you done, Stephen?
And then we get out through the window.
Of course.
So I was wondering...
You was wondering...
About Rory Sands?
Have you checked the window locks in his room?
No.
Or check if the double glazing units are the type which you could exit through?
Not as yet, no.
Well, I have, Stephen, and they're not.
Oh, sorry, Mama.
No, not at all. Well wondered, Stephen. You keep wondering. I'm wondering about that family myself.
Oh, sorry, Mama.
Family, the family, the family.
Excuse me?
I'm beginning to have a nasty feeling of a wild goose chase.
Oh, dear.
George is now talking to a counsellor.
What, Mr. Cipriano? It's only been here 5 minutes. Doesn't bode well, does it?
Sergeant Sands, counsellor.
I asked him to cover exhibits. Why is he talking...
Don't worry, he can do 10 things at once. He's great. He just said a hunch. Have you ever had...
A hunch?
Counselling.
Excuse me?
We had it at college. I just find it interesting. But now, of course, you've got your allotment.
Oh.
Well, that's therapy, isn't it?
I prefer electric shock treatment, but, you know.
What sort of things do you grow?
Well, green sort of things. Weeds, I think you call them.
The one thing I always wanted was my own asparagus bed.
Well...
Sorry, we digress. It's just a completely different taste. When it's freshly picked. Listen, I said okay to George and his hunch, but I am worried that we're putting too much into Sands' family side of things. We've got nothing on the poor victim. John Sands should be irrelevant.
Sorry. Excuse me, Mum. Hello, D.I. Raine. Hello, Mrs. Sands. What can I do for you? One moment, please. Sorry. Who's irrelevant?
Excuse me. I'm looking for someone called Muriel Sands. Oh, yeah. Yes, you left one lead.
Cheers, thank you.
Muriel.
Sorry.
It's all right. If I'd have known, I'd have brought me washing.
Oh.
The supervisor, please report to customer reception.
What's happening then, Muriel?
You've got to help us. He's not well.
He's stressed out, isn't he?
Won't go to his sessions.
What sessions?
Counselling.
Counselling? No.
He insists he's better on, though he's not.
How do you know?
Watched him cowering in the bedroom, shaking. I tell you, voluntary counselling is useless. It should be compulsory. We all have to pussyfoot around him. If he flies off the handle at the slightest thing, I'm frightened for him and for Rod. You've got to help us.
How?
Oh, for heaven's sakes.
What? Muriel, I have a man on a slab in the mortuary. You have a son who was seen running towards the scene of the crime.
No.
No, he wasn't.
Of course not.
You know that?
Yes.
Why did you ring me, Muriel?
What? I foolishly thought, being a woman, being in the force, you might understand my position. My family is falling apart round my ears. No one speaks. The kids loathe John.
Why?
He's always been very strict, but it's not that now. I tell them he's ill, but
they can only make so many allowances, eh?
It's not fair on them. And the police. The police who got him into this mess have done absolutely nothing to help him. In fact, you raid the house, detained my son. I hate the police and I wish he'd never joined, and I hope you realise how you humiliated him yesterday, but you won't. Just come in and walk away.
Let me assure you of one thing, Muriel. We are not walking away. We can't. Your son could end up being charged with murder. Would he lie to protect him?
Who? John.
If he's not well, if he can't take any more aggravation. Or Sarah, would she lie? The football ground is 5 minutes away from your house. Rory could have popped out, couldn't he?
I asked you to help. You stop making matters worse.
Have you ever heard anyone in your house mention the name Jason Hurley? Sarah, please. We need to talk. I'm here as a friend to help you. Is Rory in a mess? I know my brother used to tell me his darkest secrets. Were they dark? Are you normally all in on a Saturday night?
I hope you're being as thorough with all your other lines of inquiry. She was in all day on Saturday because she was being punished, if you must know. I found a bracelet in her room.
A present?
A gold bracelet? I did not receive a satisfactory explanation.
You snooped in my room while I was at school. I don't have to tell you who gives me presents.
Thanks a lot, John. I just wanted to...
Sarah! Sarah!
It's too late. John, you're shaking. Did you find out about Sergeant Sands for me?
I spoke to the duty officer who sent him home. He found him crying in the locker room.
Crying? Why?
For no reason. He told him he'd better go home, and he's never been seen since. 6 months.
It's terrifying. He looks so normal. Once you get into mental, I don't like it at all. You don't know what you're dealing with, do you?
No. You don't.
The atmosphere in that house, you wouldn't believe. How she copes. You can feel it. Touch it almost. Whatever it is between them, it's like a family on the edge. How people live like that under one roof. It's beyond me. It's like something's got a blow. Yeah. Maybe that's it. It's like a pressure cooker.
thank you. It's all for a good cause, yeah. I've got to sort her out. Now listen, these are powerful cars and they're not the Dodgems, all right? Give yourself space, drive slowly and carefully until you get a feel for the car. Blimey!
I think your voice has done it before, mate.
Yeah.
You smell of the sea, you do.
There you go.
Thanks. Where'd you get all those?
It's for my own personal use.
That's not what I asked.
Maisie, I thought you'd knocked off for the day. Give it a rest. Relax. This is not out in this country yet.
Where'd you get it?
Maisie, I have friends, okay?
Has it got the hologram?
I doubt it.
Kelvin, I've told you before!
Maisie.
I am not watching dodgy videos!
You've watched them before. What's the problem?
Do you know what I am doing now?
Shouting.
I am consulting with a criminal.
I am not a criminal. That's horrible.
Dodgy bacon? Dodgy videos? How many times have I got to tell you? You could cost me my job.
Calm down. There's no need to go mental.
I am not going mental. Why do you think we live in separate flats?
It's only a little video.
You've just raised £400.
Brilliant.
Should we go to the pub?
I've got a nice cold shabby in the fridge.
Oh.
Don't want to drink and drive, do you?
What are you going to do, arrest me?
Well, I've got the handcuffs. I beat you.
Hey, hang on a minute. You didn't beat me.
Mixes with the very worst. Always bunking off. Unfortunately, she's just determined to be bad. Often happens. Vicar's sons, policemen's kids. They want to prove they're not goody-goody. They want to be accepted, you know. No one likes being different, do they?
And is Rory into proving himself?
You'll have to ask his teacher. I have taught him. He looks hard, but you know, boys, I think he's a bit of a softy underneath. I'm not sure I can say the same for Sarah, though. Not since she got in with the gang. Maybe she's cleverer than most. Doesn't get caught.
Sarah had a bad chest infection this week.
See? She can spell infection.
Morning, Princess.
This is too early, you know.
Jason Hurley.
Yeah. Oh yeah, stabbed.
We know that. Drugs?
I don't know. He'll knife you as soon as look at you.
Yeah, he wouldn't knife himself though, would he?
Might. He was in the pub till 11.
Yeah, when?
That night. Well, no one talked to him though, because no one likes him.
Which pub?
Peacock.
Want some breakfast?
I'd be sick.
You need to eat something.
Fancied himself as a bit of a wheeler dealer, you know, big time, like trying to flog posh watches and that. Trouble is, right, everyone except him knew they was fakes. What an idiot.
Well, someone